Update: Ayo Buhari's government won't kill Nnamdi Kanu as military regime did to my father, MKO Abiola's daughter says. You're welcome to the news. Please listen to the details carefully. And don't forget that you can share this news with your friends. The news details: The daughter of the acclaimed winner of the 1993 presidential election, Abiola, says she is afraid Kanu may end up the way her father did. Tundu Abiola has expressed fear over the life of Nnamdi Kanu, leader of the indigenous people of Biafra. Tundu, who is the daughter of late politician and business mogul, late Chief MKO Abiola, expressed concern, warning the Muhammadu Buhari-led government to make sure Kanu does not die in the custody of the Department of State Services, DSS. The daughter of the acclaimed winner of the 1993 presidential election, Abiola, says she was afraid Kanu should not end up the way her father did, in the hands of Nigerian former military dictator Sani Abacha. Abiola had died in the custody of the military junta, having been detained for 4 years. Ms. Abiola also begged Nigerians to desist from utterances that could aggravate Kanu's sufferings, adding that the Buhari administration was not different from a military regime the country experienced in the 1990s. Tundu, disclosed all this during an interview with Arise TV on Monday, while responding to questions on how the pro-Biafra agitator had been subjected to solitary confinement, as revealed by his lawyers last week. Recall that both Aloy Ejimakor and Ifeanyi Ejiofor had told the media that the Department of State Services, DSS, has subjected their client, Kanu, to all manners of torture, including restricting him from changing his customized fending clothes, not offering him medical services, making him sleep in a tiny cell without a pillow, not allowing him to have reading glasses, and many more. Reacting, Tundu, a United Kingdom trained lawyer, said, "I have first-hand experience of this, and all I can say like this for Nnamdi Kanu is I hope he doesn't go through this for 4 years as my father did. 4 long years. That was his reality, that is Abiola reality. And the next thing is that this report came out and will make the federal government look bad. The next thing is that they could stop people from seeing him at all. He would just be there all by himself. No access even to a doctor, to a lawyer, certainly no family member there as he goes through all this. I saw Nnamdi Kanu doing his court appearance as he was trying to put a brave face on things. You know men and their pride. He doesn't want to show it. He doesn't want to weaken people who really believe in him and support him. He was trying to look normal, but what he's going through is the exact opposite of normal. That's why I said on a few occasions that people should be very careful with their utterances, with their actions, so they will not get this man killed. It has happened before. It must never happen again. And it is just very sad. Here we are in 2021, after my dad died for democracy. We are still having this conversation in 2021 of somebody being treated appalling like a kind of a serial killer. Under what circumstances should somebody be treated like this? I'm hoping that the Department of State Services, DSS, would come out with a statement and completely deny these accusations and prove that the accusations are completely false and that he has been allowed a change of clothes. I mean, really, putting someone in solitary confinement is a kind of torture. Putting him in a tiny cell is a form of torture. I mean, this is sickening. The daughter of the acclaimed winner of the 1993 presidential election, the daughter of MKO Abiola Tundu, has spoken out. She voiced out and said she hopes the Buhari government won't kill Nnamdi Kanu as the military regime did to her father during the time of Sonny Abacha. MKO was in prison for, was detained for 4 good years until he died inside the custody of the military junta. They say, hope this will not happen to Kanu also. With the way things are going, with this Buhari-led government, and she's saying that people should not say what will make the government kill Nnamdi Kanu in the prison. Recall that via his lawyers, the boat came to the media and said Nnamdi Kanu, his health is worsening. He has not been allowed to change his clothes. Even his eyeglasses, the lenses, was not changed. He has been in a tiny confinement, 23 hours inside the confinement, and the only hour he has to, that he has, once he goes out of the cell, the detainees are not allowed to even salute him nor have a word with him. Anyone that does that will be punished. And this is heartbreaking. Even putting someone in a tiny confinement is a kind of torture. Will not be able to move himself. He will not be able to do whatever he wants to do. He said he was not given pillow. It was just there all by himself. And she said that very soon they might not allow anybody to come visiting, not seeing him. Hope that won't, the case of Nnamdi Kanu won't end like that of MKO Abiola. Please share your view with us. Thank you.